that. Some of you are going to get the tune right from the intro. Okay? Come on, people now. Smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another right now. Come on, people now. Smile on your brother. Everybody get together. Try to love one another. Song. Great tune by the Youngbloods, Get Together. Now, what does it have to do with this week's Torah portion of Chaya Sarah? You are asking a very good question, and I was wondering how long it was going to be before you would ask. So, let's get right into it. Short and sweet. Let's talk about the mitzvah of hocheach, hocheach, rebuking. You shall surely rebuke. It's a double expression, hocheach, hocheach. But I ask you the following question, folks. Is it the correct English translation of those words? Pretty much in every single chumash, Torah, Bible, where it's been translated, it has been translated as thou shalt surely rebuke, hocheach tochiach. In other words, that word, hocheach tochacha, means rebuke. But does it? Now, this is a little picture from my book. Couldn't resist, because this is one of the first beefs that I write about in my new book called Musings and Misunderstandings, Shedding Light on Some Common English Mistranslations of Torah. This is one of those common English mistranslations. And I'm going to show you that it's not something I made up. It's not something that I thought, oh, wow, this would be a nice way to interpret it. The proof is in this week's Torah portion, Chaya Sarah, the life of Sarah, okay, Abraham's wife. So let's get right into it. And let's see here. So if we look up, the first time that word is mentioned in this Torah portion, Eliezer is on a mission. Abraham sends him to find a suitable wife for his son, for Abraham's son Isaac, for Yitzchak. So Eliezer comes up with this plan. I'm going to go to the well, and whoever comes up to me and asks me if I would like to drink, and because this is in the desert, and will even offer to give water to my camels, then I know that she has the right character traits to enter into the house of Abraham and Sarah, who they exemplify the character trait of kindness. Without it, they're not getting in to the household of Abraham. In no way, no how. So the first time he comes up with this thing, this plan, and he says that Va'amra Shasei, and she will say to me, drink, V'gam Gumalacha Ashka, I will also give to your camels water. Oso Hochachta, this is the one that you have, whatever this word Hocheach means, La'avdacha LiYitzchak. Well, I'm pretty sure that word is used here. It doesn't mean rebuke. This is the one that you've rebuked for your servant, for Isaac. And Uva Eidai, and I will know because that you have done kindness with my boss, with Abraham. What's this hochachta? What does that mean? Right? Strange expression here. Just look up in Rashi. The Rashi right here, this you can look it up yourself. It's chapter 24. And it is the verse, it is verse 14. All right, Oso Hochachta. So Rashi says that she's worthy to enter into the household of Abraham and Sarah. V'lashon Hochachas, Bereiras, and he tells what the word is in French. This expression of Hochachta means to choose, to select. So he's given a selection process of how to determine that. All right, fine. It all sounds nice and groovy right now, something that the Youngbloods would be very proud of, but let's go further. Then Eliezer goes to Rivka's household, and he explains the whole thing over to Rivka's father and to Rivka's family. And he says, I came to the well, this is what I said, I'm on this mission. And he says over here, V'amra elai gam atasha say, and she said to me that also drink, V'gam gam alecha eshav, and also for your camels I will give. Hiya isha, this is the woman, asher hocheach Hashem levent adonecha. Again, here's that strange word that most people think means rebuke. This is the one that asher hocheach. Okay, Rashi already said it means this idea of selection. Okay, so if you look up in the Rashi, by the way, that is chapter 24, just a bunch of verses later, and it's in the verse 44. Okay, so you can look it up yourself. Rashi says over here, hocheach. This is the one that you have hocheach Hashem. Rashi says here, berar v'hodia. And this one that you have selected and made known. V'chein kol hochecha shebemikra. And so too, every time this word hocheach, tocheach, tochecha is mentioned in the entire Chumash, the entire Torah here, borar dover. It means to clarify the matter. So it doesn't mean just to go get out there and give the guy, why are you good for nothing, bum, look what you're doing to yourself, rebuke, rebuke, rebuke. No, Rashi says, every time that's mentioned in Chumash, bar or davar, it means to clarify something. So what does that mean, hocheach tochiach, then? Right, that comes later on in the book of Leviticus. What does that mean is that we should help the person, if they're having some issues, to make good choices, to select, to be selective, and to figure out what's a good way that this person should go. All right. If you hear the song I'm singing, you will understand. Love and fear, all in your trembling little hand. Just one key unlocks them both, is there at your command. Come on, people, now smile on your brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right. Now, smile on your brother, everybody get together, try to love one another right now, right now, right now. Peace out, y'all. Have a great Shabbat Shalom, good Shabbos, good weekend. Increase the peace. Yeah. And bring some of that love into the planet.